Well, hey everybody, how's it going? It's Embrace the Matrix. Hope you're all doing well today. And if you clicked on this video and you looked at the time, you'll see we're in for a long haul. Roughly an hour. We'll see if I can even talk that long. I'm used to talking, but good grief. Anyways, you know, what the hell, we'll talk about all kinds of things in this hour-long video. This is by far the longest video I've done. The total video time was almost 6 hours to paint these coffin boxes. And I sped these up pretty quickly and got it down to about 57 minutes or whatever it comes out to. So, yeah, and I mean, you know, seeing as how this video was this long, I figured why not do a voiceover, why not do some talking, and yeah, we'll just talk about a few things. And if you're one of the few people that are going to sit through this video, you'll probably hear a lot of good information and, you know, a few surprises along the way. So, got a nice cup of hot peppermint tea with some raw honey, because I've been somewhat under the weather. I don't know about you, but man, it doesn't matter the time of the year, but I have like forever sinus issues. I mean, it doesn't even matter. I wouldn't even call them allergies. I would just say I got like a sinus that hates me, I guess. I don't know. Alright, anyways, let's get started. So, yeah, coffin boxes. Whoa, what the hell? Like, why? You make an attempt at making paintings. Why are you doing painting coffin boxes? Well, I saw these things at the craft store. And obviously, they were a seasonal Halloween item. And they were pretty cool. They weren't all warped out. Like, sometimes when you go to the Michaels or whatever and you look at some of their wood crafts or their wood boxes, things are all like warped out and things don't line up and there's gaps and all kinds of things, and you're just looking at this thing like, I'm not gonna do anything with this, and it's all gapped out and warped out. But these little coffin boxes were pretty cool. They, you know, they weren't all gapped and warped out, and at first I only bought a couple. And this one here you're seeing is the first one I painted, and then I went and did five more. But you know, at first I was doing it as a break, you know, just a break from painting on canvases. And you know, I got all a bunch of brushes and I got all this paint, and I don't really use a lot of brushes for my you know, my abstract paintings, you know, not usually. Certainly not small brushes. But, so I saw them and I thought, well, you know, I'll just get them and, you know, I'll just try to paint them up different and see what I can do with them. And, then, you know, I got to thinking, like, these are pretty cool. I mean, you can see the skulls in the background that I did previously. Those were, you know, those were another, you know, craft store find, and, you know, obviously a Halloween theme. And I just thought it'd be cool to do something just a little different. You know, some people paint shoes and cars and whatever. I just thought, you know, what the hell? I mean, I'm of the dark arts. But yeah, I thought I would do these coffin boxes. And let me tell you, I put a lot of time and effort into these. I'm actually doing the second coat. I did, for the most part, I did 2 to 3 coats of paint on the inside and the outside. And then I didn't do as thick of a coat of paint on the edges, you know, the where they close, because I didn't want them to not close, you know, or just be all gapped out or whatever. But on the outside and the inside, yeah, I got solid coverage. Because believe it or not, I mean, and I'm sure you can, wood absorbs acrylic paint like nobody's business. I put a lot of time in these. I'm actually going to be selling these too, not to get too far ahead, but I'm doing my first arts and crafts show on the 12th, this Saturday. So if you're local to Northeast Ohio, you know, there's a, well, we'll see, but should be a pretty cool art show in Strongsville, and I, the Matrix, will be there with a bunch of paintings and these coffin boxes. So that's the 12th, all day, pretty much all day on Saturday, the 12th. We'll see. It's my first like arts and crafts show, so they're supposed to have all kinds of stuff, you know, like I already seen some of the other vendors. They're gonna have, you know, there's other gonna be other painters there and stuff, so it'll be interesting. I'm not taking a table. I'm taking a small table, but I have my grid walls. I'm taking my grid walls, and we're gonna do it up. I'm actually gonna be taking a bunch of smaller paintings, just to be able to maximize maximize how many paintings I can get. So I'll be I'll have a lot of 12 by 12s and 16 by 20s and stuff like that. So and I didn't even, when I put this video together, because there was like over 30 clips, well over 30 clips on this, I didn't, usually I do a little more cleanup on the editing in between clips. Sorry to say, I wasn't about to spend the time going and chopping them up and making it super clean, because I knew I was going to speed it up anyways, and talk over it, so yeah. What more can I say? Coffin boxes, man, these are really cool. So pick one up. I'm gonna be selling them. I don't even know how much I'm gonna sell them for yet, to be honest. I don't know, man. If you're listening to this, leave a comment below and tell me what you think you'd pay for an item such as this, hand painted. And I even went and I matte varnished them. I didn't gloss varnish them because I didn't want them to be sticky, and because they're going to open and close. So I actually spray matte varnished them inside and out, and I think they look dope. I mean, I've already had some people around here, plus some of my employees that work with my main business, that have seen them, really dig them and think they're pretty cool. And but as you can see, you know, I took the hardware off them. You know, I try to do them as good as I can. Sorry, I'm sneaking in a little touch-ups on some of these other, these skulls, while I had certain colors out. But as you can see, I took the hardware off, and it was just screwed in. You know, brass, little, looks like brass. I don't know what it is. Probably not brass, but brass-colored hardware. And obviously, I took it all off. To make sure we had good painting. Now, lost a clip of where I actually sprayed the paint on this one. So, sorry. But don't worry, you'll be seeing it in other ones. But this is basically, this is the first one I did. So this is, I just did one, and I wanted to see how it turned out. And this is, of course, after I spray varnished it, and then I put the hardware back on. I don't videotape me varnishing, because it's just me spraying it with a spray can of, you know, matte varnish. Not that exciting. Well, we'll say it's less exciting than this, watching me screw, so to speak. But don't worry, I saved a good nice long clip at the end where I gotta put all the hardware back on all the other five, and there's a nice sped up clip of me screwing. So you'll see a lot of me screwing shortly. Well, not shortly, but in a little bit. So, yeah, so this is putting, and they all went back together great. I mean, look, I mean, it goes, you know, they close just right. They don't stick. There's no gaps. And you'll see that in the other ones. But for this first one, Obviously, I did crimson on the interior, black on the exterior with a crimson splatter paint job. And this is the first one, and I think this one turned out really cool. I mean, look at that. Dude, you could, like I say, you know, I said on my website, you could fit a small toddler's, you know, a toddler's hand in there. You could, you know, fit about 5 grams or maybe more of cocaine, whatever you want. You can put whatever, listen, you can put whatever you want in this box, whatever you think will fit in the box. So they're like little trinket boxes, jewelry boxes. I don't know what other kind, what else could you put in this thing? I don't know. I would think, you know, if you have a little voodoo doll, that would look great in there. They actually have these really cool at the craft store, or at Pacatan's, which is a local craft store, I think. They have these things called Watchover Voodoo dolls, and they're more like talismans, sorta. But they're actually really cool, and that those would fit perfectly in here. They're just the perfect size to fit in one of these boxes. So yeah, you know, if you're watching this and you sit through any length of this video and you see this and you're interested in one of these, I went out and hit every craft store that had these, and it was Michael's. Was it Michael's? I can't remember. It was Michael's. I believe that had them. I'm sorry. Pardon me. It was Pacatan's that had them. And I went to the two closest Pacatan's and bought them out. So I have about 10 more of them. So if you see, you know, if you're watching this and you see it and you go, man, I want to have one of those. And even more importantly, if you have colors that you would like me to paint. And I mean, we don't have to get down to specifics. I mean, you gotta leave me with a little bit of creativity. But if you say, hey man, I want, you know, the inside to be blue and the outside to be white, you know, and then, you know, go ahead. I'll do it. I'll do it up. I think when it comes down to it, I'll probably charge like 30 or 40 bucks for these. Not a tremendous amount of money. Given the amount of time, I mean, there's, like I said, there's a lot of time in doing this. I apologize for this office phone ringing. Hopefully one of the girls here will answer it quickly. It took a lot of time, especially when you're doing multi-layers, you know, and I didn't mask anything off. So, you know, you can see around the edge there, yeah, there's paint, but I'd come over it and clean it up and stuff. But I didn't mask anything off. I just used my very delicate touch, which up until this point, I didn't realize I even had a delicate touch when it came to painting. And, of course, when I painted these, I used nothing but Golden, Liquitex, and Gallery Windsor paints. So all high-end paints. You know, except for the Galleria, but, you know, for the most part, I was using Golden and Liquitex on these, just because I knew that the wood was going to absorb some of the paint, and that I wanted to make sure it went on thick. And even though, you know, with the imperfections in the wood and stuff on these things, I had, and using, you know, I mean, Golden and stuff, I had to put multi-layers on. Because even with that, it came through, and I didn't mix the paints with anything. I usually mix it with gloss latex, gloss gel medium, and I didn't want to do that, obviously, because I don't want it to be glossy. I wanted them to have more of a matte type, you know, darker finish. Even though I knew from the beginning I was going to matte varnish them, because there's no way you're going to gloss varnish something like this. You want to protect it, you know, people are going to have it, and you might spill something on it or whatever, but, they've been thoroughly varnished, so they'll be protected. And again, you know, with the thickness, you know, the multi-layers in the paint, I mean, I made sure that there was no bubbles, drips, you know, buildup of any paint. I was pretty meticulous about how I did it. And I had fun with it. I mean, to be honest, this was something different. Like, I don't really stress when I paint. Obviously, painting for me is a de-stressor. And I use painting to relax and just try to chill out and stuff. Unfortunately, with my crazy schedule, my paint, you know, when I paint, it's not like, okay, you know, I'm certainly not a full-time artist, and I'm, you know, not just sitting around painting all day. I either paint very early in the morning or generally late at night, after everybody goes to bed, so I can chill. But for these, because, you know, I'm just painting small areas, and I was doing layers, then, you know, I could throw a layer on here or there, middle of the day, go down, throw a layer on, put my fan on, let it dry, you know, come back in a couple hours and throw another layer on. And, you know, it took weeks. I mean, I know the total video time was over 6 hours, almost 6 hours. But this actually took me weeks of time, because while doing these, I was also doing some paintings because I wanted to have some new paintings for this art show coming up. So I've been working on some new stuff that I've put out. I got about 4 or 5 more paintings to release that are already done. The videos are, I'm working on editing the videos and stuff. So I got a bunch of stuff coming out, coming soon. But, you know, like I said, if you're just into the creative process, this is a great video for you. You can watch me just paint away on these things. And be as careful as I can, especially when you get to the inside, that inside edge. You have to be real careful. I mean, the outside and the inside is great, but when you get to that edge that touches, you know, you have to be very careful. So anyways, so please, man, you know, the other thing too I want to talk about because I was getting ready to say, please leave comments if you're if you're watching my videos and stuff. It seems like more people comment from across the water, like in Europe and France, and they comment on my videos, and they obviously they comment in their language, so I have to go and translate their comment or sections of their comment so that I could see what they're asking or they're telling me. And for the most part, it's been positive. I think, honestly, I've only gotten like one negative comment on any of my videos, and I don't even remember what it was, but it was definitely not positive. It was certainly a negative comment, but that just must be, you know, your typical hater, troll, or whatever. I personally don't care. If there's people out there that do like my painting, do like my creative process, do like the fact that I do make videos showing this, and even more so the fact that, you know, I'm not a true professional in that regard, and, you know, I do this for, you know, fun first and foremost, you know, for therapeutic reasons, stress reliever. And, you know, it's just helped me relax, and it's fun. You get to be creative and, you know, play around with stuff. And, you know, here we go, like double layering, as you can see. So, but no, I appreciate everybody's support that I've gotten so far. Keeping in mind, you know, I just started painting, you know, full on in January of 2016. So I've only been at this a relatively short period of time, obviously compared to some other people that have been doing it for many, many years. And, you know, again, I mean, I'm learning every day. I'm learning something new every day. I love to paint. I love to be creative, and I'm trying to come up with new ideas and new techniques and new things that people aren't doing. I know it's very difficult to come up with something new under the sun because everything's pretty much been done, but I'm certainly trying to, you know, come up with new creative things to do. I think my Fusion series and my Lifeline series are very, very unique. And I personally haven't seen anybody else do anything like that. So, you know, I'm going to hold those to my own until somebody comes along and says, somebody else was painting, doing Lifelines, you know, 10 years ago. sorry, dude. You're not the first. I go, well, whatever. But, yeah, I paint first and foremost for myself, therapeutic reasons. Obviously, I'm at the position where I'm trying to sell paintings. That has been, you know, obviously very challenging, trying to get your name out there, trying to build a brand, and find, more importantly, find your knit, you know, your direct market, which is what I'm trying to find. So yeah, if you're somebody listening to this and you see these paintings and these videos and you're interested in any of these, I don't have every single one listed on my web store, but believe me when I say 99% of the paintings I do are available for sale. So if you do see something that I've done and you're interested in it, please do not hesitate to send me a message through any one of my many social media options, or go through my website, or just send me an email at embracethematrix@gmail.com. Let me know which one you want. Let me know which one you want, and we'll go from there. But yeah, they're all pretty much for sale. I mean, I, for the most part too, when I finish a painting, I gloss varnish them. So there's a few that I've done that I've matte varnished just because I felt like that's what that painting deserved. But for the most part, I gloss varnish. So, but yeah, as you can see, I'm doing the edge here. This was the most, I guess, stressful part, you know. Trying not to go over the edge into the inside. And yeah, you have to be pretty delicate to not do that. But the thing is, if you do, you just grab the green and you go and you just go back over it when it dries. So, you know, no harm, no foul. But with the layers I put on, and you know, the other thing too, and I think I've said this before, that, you know, these videos are great and I love making them and stuff, but they never look as good as they do in person. Like, you're looking at that going, yeah, that's green and black, but when you see it in person, I mean, it's like green and black. I mean, it just really jumps out at you. And I'm shooting in 1080p, 30 frames per second, I believe. So I mean, you know, and I don't have as many lights as I should have in this new area as opposed to my old setup, but I'm working on that. So yeah, so let's see what else is going on, man. Actually, there's a few other things going on right now, and we're almost 22 minutes into this video, and if you're still hanging with me, man, good for you. You are a trooper, because like I said, this one's a long haul, and I'm going for the trip, so you need to come along with me. I'll be right here. You just sit back, grab your favorite beverage, and, you know, we'll go on for the next, 38 minutes. And I'll keep talking, and you'll keep listening, and you can keep watching. So, okay, a couple things. One, this is not my official video for this. Oh, here we go. Before I get further ahead. Here's a little the splatter splatter on this one. I did a few different things on each one. But on a couple of them, I love the sling paint, so we had to do a little paint sling in here. And, there's a little beard, dangle. Then, yeah, of course, you have to, pull the top off so they don't dry together, and then you got to cut them apart. Whoa, what's going on, man? Whoa, what the hell is this? I don't remember this in editing. Whoa, this is trippy. Maybe we entered like some one of those interstellar, wormholes or something. Nah, it's just a kaleidoscope effect. It's okay. All right, we're back. But yeah, here's another one. Here's that red one I was working on. Of course, we had to do a Lifelines, coffin box. Why not? But of course. So yeah. Definitely check it out. It's awesome. I think this one turned out one of the best. Absolutely. And of course, step by step, you got to do each side, and you have to wait till each side dries. I didn't have to wait overnight per se, because like I said, I have a fan down in my area, and I just put the fan on them and let the fan help speed up the process. But anyways, what was I going to say? Okay, so this is not my official video for this, but since you're watching this video and I got to fill up 57 some minutes of chit-chat, I'm going to let you guys know that I did hit over 500 subscribers on my YouTube channel, and in fact, it's up to like over 550 at this point. And I've said a long time ago, not that anybody's holding it to me, that when I hit 500, I was going to have a contest. Well, I am going to have a contest. I'm going to have one real soon. So you're going to be able to win free shit. Who doesn't love free shit? I do. Everybody does. I'm going to make it open to the entire planet. The entire solar system. In fact, yes, I'm going to make the contest available to the entire, not only our solar system, but all like 5,000 other solar systems. I'm still tripping on like Interstellar and stuff like that. And then of course when you see a movie like Interstellar and then you start Wikipedia or Googling shit and you're like, oh, there's, you know, 1,000 suns the same size as our sun, and there's, you know, 5,000 solar systems, and we're just a little microscopic little dust blip on the, you know, in this whole world or whatever you want, universe, whatever, however you want to call it. So anyways, yeah, I'm opening up the contest to everybody. Anywhere, any alien, interstellar creature or whatever. Yeah, it's available. This contest will be open to everybody, not only on the planet Earth, but the entire existence. Yeah, everything in our entire existence. What will you win? That's what I'm working on right now. Of course, I might throw a painting in there as an option. Because I have plenty, but I have a couple other ideas of some stuff I want to give away, so I'm working on it. I haven't really put my official video out announcing it yet, but I will. And you know, 500 subs is not at all a big number in the YouTube world, but for somebody that just started at the beginning of the year, I think it's a good first milestone. And I plan on rewarding people for being a sub and, you know, for watching my videos and, you know, especially the people that comment and thumbs them up, you know, is that how they say it? Like up my videos. Yeah. Thread banger-ish. If you like up this video, you know, unlike other people that, you know, make videos and stuff, I'm not doing it for money. I'm not doing it for ads and stuff. I have my ads turned on. I think I'm up to like $4 or $5 in ad revenue, so I don't know where I'll spend that. But I'm certainly not doing it for the ad money. I'm doing it for the exposure. I'm doing it for people to learn about me, my painting, my philosophies such as they are. You know, why I paint, and you know, just, you know, me myself. I mean, you're buying art, but you're buying, you know, a person too. You're buying a piece of that person. That's how I feel about it. So, you know, this gives you an opportunity to learn more about me and, you know, my art and who I am and why I do what I do and why I say what I say and look the way I look or whatever. So you get a little more personal, little personal touch here. I mean, you know, you can go buy art from other artists and you never hear from them, you never see them, you never, you know, or maybe you see them, but you know, they don't, you never hear them talk about anything, and you know, you don't understand them on a more personal level, which is what I'm trying to do. And I think in this day and age with social media and stuff, yeah, you're kind of missing an opportunity to really connect with fans and people that like your, whatever you're doing, whatever your product, you know, you're making or creating or whatever. Yeah, if you're not utilizing social media and YouTube and stuff, then I just think you're missing a mark. You're missing the mark big time. But yeah, so we hit the first milestone, you know, 500 subs, and we'll have a little contest, and you'll win some free shit. Who doesn't love it? Like I said, that'll be coming up soon. It'll be perfect timing too, because it'll probably happen sometime in this month or next month. I got so many things on my plate right now that, oh, and here we go. Before I interrupt, I tried that new brush, that brush I just put down. I picked these cheap-ass brushes. You can see them on the right next to the tape. I thought they would work out pretty good, but the bristles are just so limp and long, and, yeah, they're garbage. They were like 45 cents at the art store. Don't buy them. They're shit. I made like three swipes with it and pitched it. So 500 subs, awesome. I'm so happy. I just think it's great. I get new subs every single day, it seems like. I get a sub or two every day. Here, I try that brush again. Yeah, I just gave it the finger. Screw you, brush. We're gonna throw you in the trash. So let's see, what else? You know, and the thing too with YouTube, and I've gotten some feedback from people, and that's why I started doing more voiceovers, because people said they liked them. I mean, that's the most positive comments I got were on the videos where I did voiceovers and I talked, and I have no problem talking. I'm an open book. I'm a type of person that, you know, I've experienced a lot in my life, and I'm not ashamed to talk about my past screw ups and where I came from. You know, I grew up poor. I grew up on welfare. My family didn't have any money. We ate government cheese and peanut butter and stuff. You know, I'm a high school dropout. I'm a derelict. I'm an ex-drug addict, heavy drug addict. You know, and I've, you know, had a successful business for the last 10 plus years. Just started painting. You know, I've been a musician. I've been in many bands. I've recorded a lot of music. I've done a lot of different things. I've had a lot of crazy sexual escapades, just all kinds of stuff. So, but I'm the type of person that, yeah, if you want to know about some, or you want to hear a great crazy story about something, anything, certainly sex or drug related, I can accommodate you pretty well. But I'm very much an open book, you know, to anybody. I'm not, you know, I've done horrible things. I've been a jerk. I've been an asshole. Most of that time is when I was either drunk or on heavy drugs. But nonetheless, I don't deny it. I still, you know, I'm not embracing it. But it's just me. It's just what I was. And, you know, people can change, you know. I'm a firm believer in that, and sometimes people, don't get me wrong, if you're like a pedophile and you are like doing like shit with little kids or something, or you're like a rapist or something, chances are you're not going to change, because you should inherently know that that's wrong to do stuff like that, you know, or if you're like, you know, I don't know, you like to assault people or whatever, quite possibly no, but you know, if you're just like a drug addict or, you know, a derelict or whatever, and you just, you know, got a shitty attitude about things, you can't change that. Not to say that a pedophile couldn't not be a pedophile, but from what I've seen, you know, usually those guys, they go to jail or whatever, and then they get out and do the same thing again, you know, and it's pretty messed up when a veteran, you know, that's growing three pot plants to take care of his, you know, PTSD and his, you know, his pain or whatever, gets arrested and goes to jail longer than a pedophile. There's where I feel true injustice is, but I'm not going to get in all that right now. But nonetheless, people can change, and I'm a great example of it. I was a derelict. I was a, you know, troublemaker, a trouble finder, trouble looker, whatever you want to call it. And, you know, I've veered far, far away from that lifestyle and life choices. That's the thing I like about YouTube and social media, is that, you know, not only can I, you know, put this information out there, but, you know, if it helps anybody, you know, I have another channel. This is obviously my strictly art channel, but I have another channel. If you search out Sinister Minister, or you search Chuck Nation 6996, and you'll probably have more luck if you search Chuck Nation 6996, you'll find my other channel. and I have a lot of other more personal stuff on there. Not that you have to. I'm not telling you have to, but if you're so inclined to do a little searching, you can find that. And I used to do road vlogs where I would just rant and rave while I was driving. I had cameras set up microphone set up in my truck, and when I went on trips to Costco or whatever, that's like a half hour away, I would just rant about whatever was on my mind at the moment. And I started doing that, thinking that people would enjoy it, and it turns out they really didn't, or at least they didn't want to watch it. But nonetheless, I put a lot of live music. When I go to shows on my other channel, I put a lot of live music. So I'm kind of not to veer far away from the art thing, but hell, I still got a half hour roughly to talk. When I was younger and I went to concerts, I was like one of the guys. And of course, I'm a big fan of heavy metal music and rock and roll and stuff. But I would be the one in the pit all the way up front, getting crazy, getting nuts. No matter what, I was always in the pit and all that. And as you get older, you don't necessarily want to be in the pit. You want to sit back and watch the show. Although the last few shows I've been to, which the last couple major shows I went to was Korn, Suicidal Tendencies, and Amir and Attila, I was in the pit for those two, as close as I could get. But I know how some bands are. They're like, oh, you don't want to watch the show through your phone and don't record and stuff like that. Look, one of the main reasons I do it is not so I can look back and have memories, because I was at the show. I don't need to do that. I have a memory in my brain, and no matter the large amount of drugs I did, I still can remember things. But I do it because, a lot of bands don't tour like they used to, because the market isn't what it is. So, there's people in areas that never get to see certain bands. So, and I'm in a suburb of Cleveland. So, and even with that, I'm in a major metro, and they don't, a lot of bands still don't come to Cleveland. So if they do, I have a Galaxy Note 5, that I've had. I had a Galaxy Note 4 that I've used to record. I used to have a flip cam, one of those flip deals that used to take okay stuff, but of course it became outdated relatively quickly. And I just use my Note, and I get really good quality video. I just went and just shot stuff for the Attila show. I missed a mirror this time, but I've seen a mirror before, and seen him on stage. I watched him from the stage, so I got a cool perspective. But I do it because there's people in other countries or other areas that can't, Marilyn Manson might not come to their town and they can't see it. So I put a few videos out of that. It's not like I record the whole show. I'll record some of the songs and stuff, but I don't watch the show through my phone. I'm a tall guy. I'm like 6'3", so I just hit record and hold my hand up, and I'm watching the show, but, and I'm recording it as well. So I got a lot of that on my other channel. So if you're into seeing live metal bands, definitely go check that out, and you might see some stuff that you like. So, and I've done some stuff on, my mental health issues and stuff like that, my depersonalization, derealization and stuff, and what's helped and things like that. And I'll probably be putting out some more videos on it soon. I might even put them on this channel. I don't know. I'm trying to keep this pretty much art, art-based and stuff, so that, because, just to keep things where they're at. Here's a shot, where I forgot to turn the camera on, and I did, this one I just painted green, and I hit it with my mister. I have a spray mister that I bought for mixed media or something like that, and that's just the purple and crimson, which I thought turned out really dope. That's fresh splatter, as you can see from the table. But yeah, I used a Mr. on that other one. Mr. Remember those guys? So I used a little spray and just let it kind of fall on it. Turned out pretty cool. And then I thought, let's do an orange one. Yeah. But what color goes with orange? And what did I come up with? Well, you'll see in a minute. So if you like metal, if you like live shows and stuff, and you're, especially if you're in an area that doesn't get a lot of metal shows, go to my other channel. Like I said, just search out Chuck Nation 6996 and you'll find it. And you'll see a lot more videos of me, that's for damn sure. I don't really, that's my text message. I don't really, when I record art videos, I don't really show myself. Not that I'm camera shy, it just, you know, it's all about the art, it's not about me. I don't know about you, but I love tea. Tea. I'm a huge tea freak. I'm a tea freak? Is that a thing? Yeah, I got me some nice peppermint tea this morning. But yeah, I'm all about the tea. I actually did a video about Inca tea, which is my new favorite tea. Definitely want to check it out. Not that I'm promoting them or for any reason, because they're certainly not paying me, but it's some damn good tea. And it's all natural, organic, all that good shit. Non-GMO, whatever. So, let's see. Let's check the text message and let's see who was texting me while I am making this voiceover. Oh, it's AT&T saying, oops, life happens. Reminder, your bill is ready. Try our payment options at blah, 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 blah. Pay us, you bastard. Yeah, no, I forgot to pay you. That's all right. They send me reminders. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice when people remind you of the bills you have? Just lovely. So, let's see. Where are we at here? Okay, 41 minutes in. You guys, if you're still with me, 41 minutes in, damn, man, you are a trooper, and I haven't even talked to you about another important thing I want to talk about, and I definitely wanted some feedback on this. So if you're one of the three or two people that actually sat through this long and got to this point, I'd like to hear your feedback on something I'm going to talk next about. I've been doing thinking. That's a terrible way to say this. I have been thinking about, hold on a second. What color are we going to do on the inside? Iridescent silver or whatever it's called. So yeah, orange and silver. That goes together, doesn't it? I don't know. Maybe. Oh, I think it turned out awesome. Of course, you had to put a few layers of silver on because the silver really soaked into the wood. But I think the orange one, the orange box here came out super cool. But anyways, so what I've been thinking about is doing, and I've actually been thinking about this for a long time, many years. I've been thinking about doing a podcast. And I wanted to do one before. I had a buddy I don't really talk to anymore, and he was just really bizarre like I am and just had real weird thoughts and crazy thoughts, and we always cracked each other up, and I'm like, dude, we should do a podcast because we're like two twisted individuals and our conversations should be recorded and put on the internet because people are going to just lose their mind when they hear some of the shit we say. Alas, it never happened. And actually, I bought a bunch of equipment. Now, I have a bunch of recording equipment because I do music. I play music, and I record music. So I have a lot of recording stuff. I have mics and all that thing, and all those sorts of things, mixing boards and all that good stuff. So I've been thinking about doing a podcast, and I really just started really thinking about it the last few days. And I wanted to do one that's obviously art-based, but artist-based. So I wanted to include, you know, musicians and artists and stuff like that. Oh, there you go. There's a quick, super quick clip. I didn't get the video of me putting a black dot on the other box. But anyways, so I thought about doing a podcast and getting artists on there, whether you're a known artist, an unknown artist, like myself, and just talking openly about art and the creative process. And there's a few art podcasts out there. There's not a lot, though, at least not that I could find. The one I listen to the most when it comes to art is Transgression, which is the Damian Echols podcast, which is very cool. And David Stupakis, I think, who's just an awesome artist. And, you know, they do a really cool podcast, talk a lot about things and give you good insight into, you know, the art side of world, art world and stuff. I know The Abundant Artist is another one. I don't know if he necessarily does a podcast, but maybe he does. I don't know. I follow Corey and stuff, and he definitely puts out a lot of great information. I'd love to talk to him. But anyways, yeah, so I would like to know if any of y'all that are watching these videos would be interested in hearing guys or girls talk about art, and musicians maybe talking about, you know, being in the music, doing music, creating, doing music. There we go again, doing music. That's stupid. Making music. You do your girlfriend or you do your wife. You don't do music. But anyways, so yeah, I got a few ideas for like the name and stuff, but basically I wanted to do it, you know, centering around artists and, you know, artists, not just art, you know, painters and stuff, but creative people, whether you're a sculptor or, you know, you paint or you're a musician, or you do poetry or whatever. I mean, if you're a creative individual, I want you to be on my podcast and talk about whatever, you know, talk about anything. That's the thing. We can talk about the creative process, talk about art, talk about struggles. I could tell you this, I could talk a lot about the things the problems I run into from this art side of things, and where I find I'm struggling the most. But anyways, yeah, so man, if you've made it this far, if you made it 46 minutes through this video, please comment below and let me know what your thoughts are. Would you be interested in a podcast, you know, about, you know, art and the creative process? What I think is really cool is that you can like host them on or put it on like SoundCloud. And I love SoundCloud on my phone because I can listen to stuff and still use my phone. Like if you're on YouTube, you know, then you have to just watch YouTube. Sometimes I want to just listen to YouTube, you know, like Joe Rogan does a great podcast and he puts it on YouTube. Well, I'd like to, like to be able to put it on YouTube and be able to do other things on my phone, but obviously you can't. But on SoundCloud, you can. So I would definitely be putting it there primarily. Again, I'm not in it for money and stuff. It's just more the exposure and to network with people. And, you know, as a listener, you can learn stuff, get educated, come up with maybe ideas. Maybe you're an artist and looking for, you know, to listen to other people talk about, you know, things they've tried and failed and stuff like that. I don't know. But, you know, and I got a sort of a weird sense of humor, and of course I'd bring that to the table, you know, and hopefully it fits with people's, you know, personalities, but, the understanding of such. But nonetheless, yeah, definitely let me know if you'd be interested in hearing such a thing, because I'm very, very interested in doing it, and furthermore, I have all the equipment, so, you know, I'd be looking for a potential co-host, you know, somebody that would want to do it regularly, or, you know, definitely looking for people that would be interested in being on it. So if you're one of those people that said, look, man, if you're going to have a podcast, I definitely would like to, you know, be a guest or listen in, you know, or, you know, join a conversation and stuff, let me know, because I'd be very interested in, you know, getting a roster together of people interested in this. And, you know, it's all about marketing and branding and, you know, promoting yourself as well as myself. And obviously I'm doing it because I want to promote myself a little more and different avenues. And I'd like to talk. Like, I'm sitting here for an hour talking to you guys, you know, and I'm sure more than half of you bounced off of this and were like, fuck man, I got shit to do. I don't have time to listen to this dude rattle on about coffin boxes and whatever else he's talking about. I mean, really, what did you think I was going to talk about coffin boxes for an hour? Yeah, no, there's not too much to say about them. Other than, you know, these cool-ass stars I put all over this one in silver. So you got silver stars, or my version of a star, on the orange box, which I think turned out dope. So, yeah, I really like this one a lot. So podcast. Let me know, people. Comment below. Yay, nay, stupid idea. There's too many out there already. Whatever, you know, like I said, I got all the gear, you know, and I can talk to anybody from anywhere, you know, you can connect through Skype, you know, I do all the editing, I'll put it all together, I'll do all the legwork, I don't mind it, you know, I just want to find individuals that are interested in being part of it, and if there's people out there that would be interested in listening to it. And do you listen to podcasts? Furthermore, tell me, do you listen to podcasts? I love them, dude. I love it better than any type of radio or anything. And obviously, I know that's, you know, it's fairly much an extension of radio. But, yeah, I think podcasts are great. The Joe Rogan podcast is just wonderful. I listen to that all the time. And the other one that's great is Bill Burr. Bill Burr does his solo podcast for the most part, and it's just absolutely awesome. And, you know, I could do it on my own and talk, but, you know, I'd like to be engaging with people and certainly bounce things back and forth. So, yeah, that was the other thing I wanted. Like I said, I wanted to bring up, you know, obviously hitting the 500, over 500 sub mark was great and a cool milestone. But, yeah, the podcast thing, too, is right on the cusp of that. And come on, man, it's winter. Ain't no nothing to do. Let's sit around and rap about art and music and the creative process and, you know, why we do what we do and what we're trying to accomplish with what we do and all that jazz. I mean, I think it'd be interesting. I mean, I'm the type of guy that if I see a movie and I like it, especially, you know, if it has a lot of effects and stuff, a lot of green screen, a lot of CGI, I'm the type of guy that I can't wait for it to come out on DVD because I just want to watch all the behind the scenes shit. And nothing bums me out more than movies that come out on Blu-ray and they don't have any type of extensive behind the scenes. Because, man, do I love that. I love behind the scenes stuff almost more than the movies in some scenarios because I'm just that kind of person. I just like seeing how things were done. And, you know, why they did this that way and that this way and all that jazz. So, I think it would be cool. I think it would be a really cool podcast. Again, because there's not a whole lot of artist podcasts out there. Okay, here we go. Oh, now, yeah, see, I'm looking for something on my phone to listen to because I know it's going to take me a little while to do some screwing. Listen, I promised you you're going to get to watch me screw. Didn't I promise you? Now, if you've made it all this way, get ready, because I'm about to start screwing. And I'm not going to stop screwing until every screw has been screwed back into these boxes. So, they've all been matte varnished. Took them all outside in the pieces, and I matte varnished them all. And, yeah, now we got to put them back together. So we're going to screw for the next few minutes. Aren't you glad I sped this up? At least this part of it? I know I am. So, yeah. So we're putting them all back together. And you know what? Surprisingly, maybe surprisingly, not surprisingly, they all went back. Because I didn't know. Like, after I put all this paint on here, I was like, man, what's... Are they going to close right? Is it going to sit right? I have no idea. None whatsoever. And you know what? They all closed beautifully. They don't stick. They function great. Yeah. It's, talk about, because after all that work, if they weren't, like, didn't come together right or didn't close right, man, I'd be pretty bummed out because I put a tremendous amount of work into these little boxes. And like I said, I got more. So if you're like, I don't like green, I don't like black, I don't like purple, I don't like red, I don't like orange, I don't like silver, I don't like red, I don't like white, hit me up with the colors. If you say, man, I want one of these custom Embrace the Matrix painted coffin boxes, you know, tell me what you want, I'll make it happen. See, look, I'm just like checking it out, like, damn, this is awesome. This thing is opening and closing just like I expected to. Yeah, everything lined up great. I'm so happy. The only thing, if I could complain about anything, was maybe finding different color hardware. Unfortunately, I'm limited to the little hardware that it came with. But believe me when I say the hardware is, yeah, you're not paying attention to that. You're looking at that dope-ass paint job on there. So, yeah, we're going to screw. And, of course, I'm in a hoodie because when I was doing this, it was cold. And the weather's been so goofy here in Cleveland because one day it's like 75. The next day it's like 45. So it's like, do I wear shorts? So I kind of like split it and I'll wear shorts and a hoodie. That way I'm not freezing, but I'm not too hot. So that's my style around this time of the year. I'll wear shorts and a hoodie, long shorts and a hoodie, because you just don't know. You don't want to be too cold and don't want to be too hot. And I'm the type of guy that I'll sweat in the middle of winter. I don't care. I'm a sweater. Sweater? I'm not a sweater like you wear a sweater, but I tend to sweat. You know, when I'm active, not just sitting around. I'm not like that, please. So we're wrapping this up. This video is going to be about an hour long. Longest video. I promise I will not make any other videos this long. And the thing, too, was I could have done each one of these individually videos for each coffin box. But that would have taken a ridiculous amount of time. And I just figured this first run, let's just put them all in one video. So that's why this is so long. That's why, you know. But hey, look, we talked about all kinds of stuff, you know. You learned about my other channel. You learned about, you know, a little bit about my past. You know, if you really want to know a lot about me, go to my website and look at my about page and my bio. And you'll see I got a nice, you know, 4 or 5 paragraphs there of very personal, you know, information about why I do what I do, and you know, why I started painting and all that jazz. But yeah, so if you're in the local Cleveland area, and I know a lot of you aren't, but if you are, definitely come out. You know, I'll be posting on my Facebook, and please, if you're looking at this video, or you're following any of my, you know, if you're watching any of my videos, go throw me a like on Facebook. I primarily post on Facebook and Instagram. I do stuff on Twitter, but I'm primarily posting stuff on Facebook and Instagram. So definitely, you know, but that's it. Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. I'm not doing every Tumblr and this and that and all these other. Those three plus YouTube, that's it. And that's enough for me, believe me. If none of these sell, or if some of them sell, whichever ones don't sell, when I come back, or you know, after my show on the 12th, I'll be putting them on my website. And if you're interested, they'll be there. I'll list them individually. And here we go. Here's some close-ups. There's some in-process stills, and you know, just giving you an idea. This was, like I said, this was the first one. The black and red was definitely the first one. And just look at that. Look at that awesome color, you know, combination. That's just beautiful. And these are just some in-process stills I took while I was doing them. While I was putting them together. Giving you an idea of just the process. And like that purple one looks super dope. And the green and black one looks... That's like my typo negative box. This one reminds me of like the Japan flag for some reason. It must be the red and white. I don't know. Like, isn't the Japan flag like red and white or something? But I'm thinking about doing some other ones with the lifelines on it. So, and that's the thing, if you see it and you want specific colors or something, and you say, yeah, do the lifelines thing, or do a splatter, or do stars, or do whatever, I can do it. It's not a problem. Hey man, here we go, we're rounding the corner, a few more seconds, and then we'll get you out of here. This is my high def photos of these things. Look at that. Aren't those beautiful? They just look amazing. Anyways, thanks for being a trooper, sticking with me through the hour. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. We're gonna see you in the next video. Take it easy.